Hi guys, welcome to my next tutorial. Today we will be making this beautiful shaker album. So as you can see, it has this beautiful shaker elements and glitters, and it says our love story begins here, and it has beautiful flowers and tag element sheet from Craft Tales, beautiful ribbon here, and on the spine piece it has this flowers and this beautiful elements from Craft Tales. And this is the back. This is an 8x8 inch album with a 2 inch spine piece. Now let's open this up to see the inside. So the first page looks like this, and as you can see, we have scalloped our edges with our DMC punch here. Now you can place a picture here. Let me show you guys an example. So this is me and my best friend here. So you can just take this elements aside, and glue this down beneath these, and so that you will have a good frame of the decorative paper here. So this is what this serves for, and this one is, you know, tags from Craft Tales. So this says be my Valentine, and this says I want to be loved by you, and these are folders here. When you open this up, you'll have space to paste pictures, small size pictures here, and also you can paste it here. Now when you open this up, you'll see the pop-up element that pops up here. So it's so beautiful, guys, and you can paste your small pictures here. So this is this page, and let's move on to the next page, third page. And this page is an envelope page. So this has this beautiful envelope and beautiful tags from Craft Tales, and this opens up like this. You can pile in much more picture mats here. I have just this sheet which I put in when we were doing our tutorial. So let me just put this inside and close this up. And this one here is again a 6x4 picture mat, guys. You can place this, tuck this back behind, and you can have a good frame here. So this is what that is for. Now for this page, this is also a beautiful pop-up page. If I stand this up and open this, see, as you can see, this will just flop down, and here is the pop-up elements that are there. So it's going to be so beautiful when your loved ones are going to open this and, you know, going to see this. Then let's move on to the next page, our fifth page. So this one is just a side pocket here where you can tuck in a lot of picture mats, and it says you belong with me with a flower and these star crystals. And here also there are, you know, a lot of elements from Craft Tales. This says I love you to the moon and back, love is in the air, and forever in love with you. So here there is a cute little frames which says I love you, be my Valentine, you plus me, and adorable. So you can place two of the pictures, small size pictures here. Now let's move on to the last page. And here is again a portrait the landscape picture mat. So you can place this like this. And this is probably one of my favorite pages. Now here is the flap here. If you just pull this, you can see the waterfall. It's so beautiful. I love this page, and this is very easy to make. So this is what we made today, and as you can see, the trim, the colors underneath the trim just pops up with the light. So this is what we made, and this one says love you to pieces, be mine, follow your heart. It says you're sweet, and there is a cute little bow here with a crystal, star crystal, and few of the little body crafts flowers here. So this is what we made in our tutorial. So let's start with the tutorial now. Hope you guys enjoy it. Now let's get into our materials list, and all the pre-cuts and measurements that I have had used here is been given in the description box below. Please take a look at it before, you know, starting this album, and have all your pre-cuts ready so that we can just assemble it all on our way, and it'll be easier for us to finish our album. So let's get into the materials list now. So the first ingredient, the main ingredient that I'm going to use, is this Pearl Collection Cupid Love Paper Pack. Let me show you a few of the sheets from this. It looks so beautiful, guys. I really love their paper packs. So just I'll give you a glimpse of this paper pack. So you have two sheets of each prints, and there are 20 sheets in total, 10 designs. Look at this. It's so gorgeous, isn't it? So we will be working with this lovely paper pack here. So these are the designs, guys. That's it. So let's move on to our next ingredient. The next main ingredients are these tag sheets from Craft Tales. I'll leave you the link for these tag sheets in the description box below so that you can take a look at it. I will be using a variety of these. It's so beautiful, guys. Do check out their Instagram page so that you'll get a variety of sizes and a variety of sentiments. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. The next thing is this crystals, star crystals. I bought this from Crafteria. I'll leave you the link to the website in the description box below. The next important ingredients are these cardboards. Okay, you can use any normal cardboards that you have at your place, no problem. Then the next ingredient would be the thinner cardstock, which is thinner and flexible. We need this for album wraps. So these cardstocks. Then the next one would be 300 GSM cardstocks, which is a much more thicker one. We need this for our inner pages, foldouts, flips and stuff like that. But today we'll be making a different design. So you'll find it really easy to make this. This is a beginner friendly album. So the next thing we need is, I will be using this DMC punch. It's called the heart scallop punch, I guess. I'm not sure about this, but I will be using this one. The next main ingredient is the red tacky tape. You can buy this from Crafteria also. So I will leave you the link for this. Then the next one is the corner puncher, which looks like this. You can buy this from your DMC store. And the other thing is this ribbon, the pink color, the hot pink color. And the next main ingredient is for the shaker front. I am going to be using this DMC sequence. I will leave you the link for this. So do purchase this. You have 12 colors in it. I'll be just mixing and matching the stuff. You'll get it in a box, but I have this beautiful hanger storage thing so that I can hang it and take for easy usage. And the next one is the glitter sets. You can get this anywhere. So this one is from Itsy Bitsy Little Birdie Crafts, and this one is just from the local market, and this one is also from Itsy Bitsy, which I bought it. So I will be using some of these two. For the flowers, I have all these varieties. These are all leftovers from my previous project. So you can mix and match whatever stuffs you have in your hands. So I'll be using some of these here and few other flowers which I like, which I have it in my stash. So I'll be using these. You can use anything. Everything here which you see is from Itsy Bitsy Little Birdie Crafts. So you don't have to worry. You can go straight to the store and you have beautiful collection of flowers. You can use anything. So the next thing is the laces. So you can buy any laces from Itsy Bitsy store. It's very cute. So this is the first design and this is the second one, this is the third one. You can use anything which you have in hand. The next thing that I will be using, this bling. Okay, this one, I'll be using the gold one just to dress up our album a bit more. And then these normal, flatback pearls, okay, gems, stones. So for the glue, I will be alternating between the Camelin white glue. I love this glue. This is a very strong glue. So I highly recommend this glue. And then the Fevicol A+ craft glue. And then a scrapbooking glue from Itsy Bitsy Little Birdie Crafts. Okay. And then you have the red tacky tape too. And then the next important ingredient for our shaker element, we need the foam tape. Okay, if you have half inch, you can definitely use the half inch, but I don't have the half inch as of now, so I'm using the 1 inch one. I'll cut this to size. So the basic ingredients that you need is the Dress My Craft scoreboard. So this is my 12 by 12 inch scoreboard. So this is very important. And the next thing is a Dress My Craft trimmer. You can use any trimmer or scoreboard, but I prefer this one because it's very good. So this trimmer is 12.5 inches by 17.5 inches. So this has a trimmer as well as a scorer. So this is 2-in-1 for you guys. So if you don't want to buy a scoreboard, you can buy the trimmer, Dress My Craft trimmer. It also has a scoring tool with it, okay? So this is the main ingredient, basic ingredient. The next one is we need few of our tools, which is the cutting mat, and then our paper trimmer, some scissors, bone folder, okay? Erasers, pencils, and binder crafts, okay? Have some sizes of it. Ruler. That's it, guys. So let's start our project now. Let's get into the tutorial. So the first thing we need is the 22 inches by 10 inches album wrap. All the pre-cutting and scoring measurements will be given in the description box below. Do look at that before starting this tutorial. It will be very useful for you guys. So this is what we want first. The next thing we need is 8 inches by 8 inches cardboard piece. Let me just name it. 8 inches by 8 inches. Okay. We need 2 of those. Okay. 8 inches by 8 inches. And the next one is 2 inches by 8 inches. Okay. This is our spine piece. So this is our spine piece, 2 inches by 8 inches. We need one of this, and 8 inches by 8 inches, we need 2 of these. Okay. Now let's take out our glue. So I will be using my Fevicol A Plus Craft glue, because this is a thicker glue and you won't have any residues while placing these. Now, before that, take out your ruler and your pencil. You see the edge here. From this edge, just mark 1 3/4 of an inch. Okay. 1 3/4 of an inch. 1 3/4 of an inch, and just draw a line here. Okay, this line won't be visible after you've wrapped your album, so don't worry. Now from the top or the bottom, anywhere, you just mark 1 inch. Okay, just 1 inch for proper placement of the cardboard pieces. So mark 1 inch on the top and draw a line joining it. Okay, let me show you. The first few minutes of our tutorial will be slow, because the beginners, the learners also should catch up. So it will be little slower, but as we move on along the tutorial, we'll do it really faster. Okay, so just bear with me for a few minutes if you are already into scrapbooking and album making. So now we have finished drawing our top one and the other one. So take out your first 8 by 8 inch piece, and the first piece we'll be placing here at the corner. Okay, so you see the tip here, you'll be placing straight on the line here and on the line here. Okay, so that you'll have 1 inch gap on the bottom here. Okay, now apply glue to the back and place this like so. So as you can see, I have applied glue now on my 8 by 8 pinch piece. Sorry, now I'll be placing it straight on the lines exactly. Okay, and after placing this, I will take my bone folder and just smooth this down so that it really sticks to the paper. Okay, now you guys also should burnish it down. Now let's take out our 2 inch by 8 inch spine piece, and when we place this here, we are going to be leaving a 1/4 inch gap here. So take out your ruler and your pencil, and from the tip of this cardboard piece, measure over 1/4 inch and make a mark. Okay, now when you place this right on that mark that we made and corresponding to that line there. Okay, apply glue to the back and place this. So as you can see, I have applied glue. Now let me just place this corresponding to that line and the marks that I've made here. Okay, leaving a 1/4 inch gap. Okay, now I will burnish this down really good here. After burnishing this down, again take out your ruler and your pencil and mark a 1/4 inch gap from this spine piece. Okay, like this. Now take out your other 8 by 8 inch piece and apply glue to the back and place this on the marks you've made and corresponding to that line there. Okay. Now I am done applying glue. Now let me just flip this over and place this on the marks that I've made and corresponding to that line there on the top. Okay, so that I'm straight. Now burnish this really good. So now this is what we should have. The next thing that we are going to do is, you see the corners here, just take out your scissors and cut this at an angle here. Okay, but you have to leave a little bit of gap like this. I hope you can see. See, I've left a gap from the cardboard to this page, this sheet. So you have to leave a gap so that it will be easier for us to wrap the album. So you need not be perfect, guys. You can, this is, you will not be able to see the see all these imperfections after we wrap. So you can just be yourself, don't worry. So start cutting this from all the four sides. So as you can see, I have cut mine on all my four corners. Now since this is a lighter weighted cardstock, it will be easy for you guys to wrap. So just slowly work it out from your edges and start folding it like this. Slowly, then burnish this down really good, okay? So start folding it from all your sides really slowly. So after the sides, start doing it on the top. Start from the middle, guys, so that it will be easy and you'll not get any splits since this is a lighted weight cardstock. Use a lighted weighted cardstock for your album wraps, guys, so that you won't have any splits or something. So now for the bottom, start from the middle and just go over and just smooth that down, okay? So now our bottoms and top and sides are also ready. Now let's take out our glue and start gluing down our sides. So apply glue here completely. Okay, now just fold this over and burnish this down really good. So this is my right side, and now for the left side, apply glue like how you apply glue for the right side and just fold this over and burnish this down really good. Okay, so now my left side is also ready. Now before gluing down the top part and the bottom part, you will have two pieces of Tyvek, which is 1.5 inches by 8 inches, okay, Tyvek. Now for this Tyvek, we will be placing this right on the groove here, okay, covering it. So both will be placed like this. So apply a considerable amount of glue. For those who don't know what is Tyvek, I'll just explain you. Tyvek is a sturdy material used for buildings. You know, towers and stuff. It is a very sturdy material. It won't tear. So when you place this here, your albums are not going to tear from the spines. So that is what Tyvek is. So now we need two strips, which is 1.5 inches by 8 inches. Okay, I think I forgot mentioning it on the materials list. So now I'll just let you know. So apply glue on the back and place this right covering the groove here. So I have applied glue. Now let me just match it up with the bottom. You don't have to be perfect, guys, because we are having the spine wrap also, so you need not be perfect. So just burnish this down really good and do the same for the other thing, other 1.5 by 8 Tyvek piece, okay? So I have burnished this down really good. Now the next thing we are going to do is for the corners, just take your bone folder and just press this down like this, okay? Just turn this right like this, okay? Do the same for this side also. Just turn this like this, okay? Now start applying glue for on this part, the bottom part of the album, and just wrap this over. So start from the middle, guys, and just hold this for a minute and burnish this down really good until it glues down completely. Now as you can see, my bottom part of the album is glued down. Now let me apply glue on the top part and fold this over. So I have applied glue. Now again I'm starting from the middle and going over the sides and just burnishing this down really good. So I've glued mine down, so this is what yours should look like, and this is what your front of the album looks like. Now let's take out our next piece, which is the spine cover, and that is 7.25 inches by 7 inches, okay? So if you place this here, centered from top to bottom, you'll have, I think, a 3/8 inch difference here, okay? So apply glue to the back and place this centered from side to side and make sure you're covering the Tyvek, okay? I have applied glue and make sure that you are 7.25 inches tall and not 7 inch tall. This way, you should be 7.25 inch this way and seven inches wide. So be straight, guys, and burnish this down really good. So I have burnished mine down. Now do not close this album while this is drying. Let it dry for a few minutes and then close this album. So by the time this one is drying, let's prep for our inner pages. Let's set this album aside and let's take out our inner pages, which measures 8.25 inches wide by 7.5 inches tall. Okay, 8.25 inches wide by 7.5 inches tall. Now let's take out, and we need 3 pieces of these, okay? Let's take out our scoreboard and place each one of these on the scoreboard so that it is 8 1/4 inches wide and score at 7 3/4 of an inch. Okay, 7 3/4. Okay, and score each one of those and just fold this and burnish this down really good. Do the same for the other two also. I have scored and burnished all my three pages. Now make sure your flap is towards your left side. Okay, have this to your left side. Now take out your DMC punch. I have this heart and scallop punch. Now let's just work with one of our sheets. Here is your flap and here is your punch. Okay, this is where you don't have any score mark. Just place this inside this punch and line this up to the edge and punch. Okay, so after punching this, line this one up with this and punch it that side. So when you have this uneven edge, take out your scissors and just clip it off. Okay, now punch along this side. Okay, so this is what mine looks like. So do the same for all the other two pages. So here is your flap and here is your side where there is no score line or flap. So punch along this side here. So as you can see, I am done with all three of mine. Now I'm just going to erase this and write the right way. Once we are done, you'll not be able to see the pencil marks, so don't worry. Now let's set this aside and let's start folding our album. Now you see your spine piece here. Just place your hands here and just slowly just pull this up and you'll be just halfway through only. Okay, now place this hand here and again start slowly pulling this up so that you will have the album like this. Okay, now let's open this up and start placing our inner pages. Now take one of these and see, you see the flap here. Apply your glue on this side. Okay, and place this right on this piece here. Okay, now I'll apply the glue and show you. So I have applied the glue and you see the fold here, the piece here. Now just lift this up like this and place this center from top to bottom so that you are not going over this album piece. Okay, now leave this and start burnishing this down really good. Okay, make sure you can open and close the album. Okay, if you're not able to open and close, then you should move this piece a little bit. So make sure you're straight enough. I think I'm straight enough. Now let me just burnish this down really good. So once you've burnished this down, open this and again burnish this down from this side. Okay, and now this page is in. So this is what your page should look like. Let's just flip this over and take out the other page, and the same way, here is your flap. Apply glue to this part. So after you apply glue like this, now you can see the first page that we've placed here. Just place this right next to it, centering it from top to bottom. Okay, you should match the top of this with the other next page that you are placing. Okay, and then burnish this down really good. This is a very simple way of hinging system, guys. You don't need to work a lot with this, so it's very simple. Just you have to place the other pages right next to the previous pages. So this is very, very, very easy. If you are a beginner, I think this is the best possible hinging system that you can learn. Start doing it with. Now after burnishing this one down really good, take the last one. Again the same way, here is your flap. Apply glue to this part and place this right next to the previous one. Okay, you're applying glue, just place this right next to the previous page that you've placed and burnish this down really good. So this is what your pages should look like. Beautiful trim on the edge and it should look really beautiful. Now let's close the album. And as you can see, the pages fit really good. So you should have something like this. Okay, so now let's start decorating our cover here. Okay, so this is the fun part. Yay!